Right, so if you can't speak to whatever device you're using, let's say mobile phone or laptop, what you can do is just type the question. I'll reread your question and proceed to answer it as best as I humanly can. So I'll try not to sound silly when I answer some very difficult questions. But yeah, if you have a question, you can just type it in the chat and I'll answer it. So this session is basically something that I can say is spur of a moment thing, because I was addressing something in the Telegram channel and a lot of questions came up, and now we find ourselves here and actually doing a full length session regarding this whole $100 a day thing. And I come from a standpoint with a lot of experience regarding making actually $100 on average a day, right? So when I say on average, it basically means, let me just clear that up from the onset. Today you make $100, right? Tomorrow you don't make anything. The following day you make $200, right? Day after that you lose 50, and the day after that, let's say you make 150. But when you tally up the entire week, right, you've made $500, right? So that would be an average of $100 per day. Okay, I'm hoping that makes sense, because it's very difficult to actually make money each and every single day without fail. Okay, pretty sure there are some geniuses who do it, but for us mere mortals, you're gonna have a losing day here and there. So we just basically calculate an average rather than just a fixed amount each and every single day. Okay, especially an amount like $100 if you have a smaller company. Okay, without wasting any more time, let's just get to it, right? So what we'll answer today, right, from questions I got is how much you actually need to comfortably earn $100 a day. Okay, guys, sorry, I'm not sure what's going on here. Give me a moment to fix this. Okay, just give me a sec, guys. It's coming from some of the more common questions that I got for the past day and a half. So how much do you need to comfortably earn $100 a day, right, from someone who actually has done it before, right? And which markets to trade and why you should be trading those markets, and which strategies will work best for someone who looks to make consistent profits on a day-to-day basis, right? As I mentioned, not every single day, but on a day-to-day basis. So when you come out at the end of the week, you have, let's say, $500. The best trading times to achieve this sort of goal, right? And can trading systems also provide you with $100 a day? Can a trading robot help you to earn $100 a day? And what to do after this session, all right? So if you feel like, okay, yeah, this is something that I want to definitely go after, then you need to take a few steps, right? It's all good and well to listen to this sort of stuff, but the more important part is to practically apply whatever we learn and also find ways to improve it in the near future. So that's what we're going to be covering today. Right? Hopefully we can get it all done in the time that we have allotted. So how much do I need to earn $100? I think that's the more pressing question that most people have on their mind. And I'd like to ask a few questions. Obviously, you can ask them of yourself about how much you'd actually need to make that amount. So it firstly depends on the objective with the profit. So let's say, for example, you want to draw out money every single week. Right? You obviously want to need a much larger account as opposed to someone who's like, okay, I'm not going to make any regular withdrawals for the first couple of months. Okay. So that basically helps. Now, if let's say you want to be withdrawing funds from the account, right, after you make money, it also depends on when you'd like to do that. So sometimes you can start withdrawing and enjoying the profits way too early. Okay? I doubt there is a way too late, but there's definitely a point where people start enjoying the profits way too early, which does sort of like defeats the entire purpose of compounding your money, Okay. Now I'll say right off the bat that the more money you have in your trading account, the better,
right?
Because it allows you to risk a certain percentage of your account that is not going to wipe you out in a few, two or three bad trades, okay? Or rather, two or three trades that don't go your way. Because there's a difference between a bad trade and a losing trade. But we're not on that particular topic right now. So I'd say $100 to $1,000 can also achieve that goal, but it needs patience, right? Especially with smaller accounts. I'll show you guys what would be a relevant approach, right? If you have something better, obviously you can use that sort of method about how much you can target for the first week or second week, third week. But I would say $100 to $1,000, you can actually make consistently with patience an amount of $100 on average per day. Now, what's your risk appetite? And are you afraid of losing money? When I say risk appetite, I just generally mean it in my words, is how much can you actually take in terms of losses? Because a lot of guys will take out a $100 trading account and that's the only money that they actually have. Right? You can't have a large risk appetite then, right? But if you have a consistent flow of money coming in, now you can throw it $100 here, you know, $50 there, and you won't be too worried, okay, if things go south. If that $100 goes down to $50, goes down to $30, you're not worried at all, you know, because it's not the last amount of money that you actually have in your account. Therefore, it allows a bit of breathing room when you have to take much larger risks. So the higher risk appetite, you can start off with $100. So if, let's say, you're like, okay, no, I'm comfortable with losing $100 or $50 in a single day or $30 in a single day, then you can start off in that way, right, with $100 and risk a bit more, right? Use much larger lot sizing and target an average of about $10 per day for a full month, right? So that's one of the things that I usually say, that you can target, let's say, $10 per day with whatever strategy that you're going to be applying, and then withdraw the initial deposit and just increase your target. So instead of then, after a month, targeting the same $10, you can increase your target to, let's say, $50. And that's going to require you to increase your lot size, right, your trading volume. But you'll have your $100 back. Let's say you probably should have about $200 left in your account that you can then trade with, which is the term that I hate to use, the market's money. I hate to use that term, but for some reason I still use it. And then you can use market's money to just basically trade off and make, let's say, $50 on average per day, and then you can start increasing that till you get to that $100 daily. Okay. Now, what you need to understand about, okay, making this sort of or taking this sort of venture into consideration is that if you trade low volatility markets, let's say Australian dollar, Canadian dollar, right, you can use a bigger lot size, right? These markets don't really move all that much on a day-to-day basis. You'll find that the average daily range, for example, is 60 pips or 50 pips. And therefore, the average movement you can expect the market to move can't be that much. So you can increase your lot size on those ones. So let's say you want to start off with a 0.10, right? 0.10, that basically means for every single dollar that you earn, or every single pip rather that you earn, you get a dollar, right? So if you make 50 pips in a single day, okay, so if you make 50 pips in one full day, that would be $50, right? Hope that makes sense. Now at 0.01, that's 10 cents per pip. So if you make 50 pips, that is $5. Okay. So the lot sizing rule would be, so let's say at 0.10, right? So we're using a mini contract. Our stop loss would be, let's say, 20 pips, and our take profit would be 50 pips. Let's just say 20 pips as well. Okay. So if you're scalping, probably you're going to have 1-to-1 risk reward, right? But your win percentage needs to be very, very high, right? You need to be looking at 85, 90% win ratio, which is quite achievable if done correctly. Okay, so now market that has big ranges, like your pound Australian dollar, your pound yen. If you take the same sort of scenario or outlook with the pound dollar that, let's say, you do with Australian dollar CAD, the stop loss will typically be much larger. Right, so your stop loss will typically be much larger, and also your take profit will be typically much larger, and therefore you can reduce the amount of your stop loss, so of your lot size rather. So instead of you using 0.10, you'll probably use a 0.05 when trading the pound crosses. Right. So if you do have a small account, trade low volatility markets like Australian dollar, CAD, NZD, CHF, but take advantage of the fact that they don't move all that much. They're not that volatile, which allows you to get in at reasonably good entries. And it allows you to have much tighter stop losses, which means you can increase the amount of contracts you can buy. So your lot size can increase as opposed to trading the GBP AUD, where you have to decrease your lot size to account for the much larger stop loss. So if you have a bigger account, I didn't say big, I said bigger in comparison to a $100 account, because $1,000 is not big. But you can trade the NASDAQ 100. So I've been hounded regarding the NASDAQ 100 for the past couple of weeks. And I think obviously there's a lot of hype surrounding the NASDAQ 100. And it's a really good instrument to trade, right? Very good patterns and all that stuff. So, and the movement on the NASDAQ 100 can be very profitable, if I say so myself, and the moves can become very extended. So you can risk quite a small amount of points to gain a much larger portion of pips, you know, and the retracements are less frequent as opposed to currencies, which have obviously way more manipulation, it seems. And you have a lot of pullbacks, you know, you up $20 today, and then when you check again on the Euro USD, you are up $10, you know, and then the following day you up $50, you know, and then it pulls back down. Now you're up only $1. So there's a lot of retracement when it comes to the currencies themselves, which I do believe why a lot of people are, the NASDAQ 100 is very appealing to a lot of people. Because sometimes it just moves straight up or straight down. You know, trading strategies that work best. Right, to answer this question, obviously we need to know a few things. Now, to achieve daily profits, you need to have a very short time horizon. By that, I mean trades that you open now and close in a few seconds, or you open now and close in a few minutes, but nothing more than a day. Okay, so naturally, if you have these very short time horizons where you're looking at, let's say, 10 pips here, 15 pips there, 5 pips there, 10 pips, 15, 20, then you're going to have a lot of trading going on. You're going to trade quite a significant amount of time. And typically, I don't recommend people trade more than 2 hours straight in a row. So let's say you can break up your sessions if you want, 2 hours, you know, 30-minute break or whatever the case may be, or an hour break, and then come back for another 2-hour session. But after 2 hours, I mean, the brain starts to, you know, do things that you wouldn't normally do when you just woke up and you're refreshed and you're thinking clearly, right? And you've just listened to some motivational videos. I know a lot of you guys like that stuff. So when you're trading short-term, right, that would basically be a scalping strategy, right? So when you're scalping, you're just taking very small increments, price changes in the market, and at the end of the day, you can come up with 80 pips, you know, come up with 100 pips, not taking big chunks of the market, which sometimes can become very tricky, right? Honestly speaking, when you try to predict prices long-term, it can be very tricky because, like I said, there's a lot of retracements, Right? Market could change direction, fundamentals could change, which means that the trade that was going your direction, which is now 100 pips to your take profit, and you were like 500 pips in the green, can just suddenly pull back and you end up, let's say, with 150 pips. So that sort of stuff can happen with long-term position trading, but it doesn't seem to be that much of an issue when it comes to short-term trading. Now, if you need help finding a strategy, you can send a message via WhatsApp. I'll leave the number right at the end that you can just go through the PDF. I've sent the PDF multiple times in the Telegram channel. But if you need that, you can just WhatsApp with the number right at the end. I'll send that through to you. Okay. Now, trading times will be dictated, are usually dictated rather, by two things, right? Your schedule, right, and your strategy. So what you need to understand about strategy, or rather trading time, is that markets tend to behave differently during different trading sessions. Right? So if you're trading a momentum strategy, which means let's say a breakout sort of strategy where you expect the market to do something along these lines. Okay, let me just get my drawing tool. Okay, so if you expect the market to, let's say, Asia and break out to the upside, right, and start to trend in one particular direction or the other, you will need to be trading during the London as well as the New York session. Okay, so if you're looking for a unidirectional swing, or just the market to move in one particular direction, your best bet is to trade during the London as well as the New York session. But if you're looking for ranges, right? Ranges would be markets that move up, down, you know. Those markets can also be traded quite effectively so, right? I've known some strategies that include the Bollinger Band, right, and just a simple exponential moving average, right? Not a simple moving average, but rather exponential moving average, and let's say something like, not quite certain, but it looks like the parabolic SAR or something like that. Okay, there was an indicator this guy was using quite a while back, and it was actually working very well for him, and it was just simply selling at these highs, right, and buying at these lows when the market is still. That's usually when the Asian session is in play, right? The markets will move sideways a bit, right? Now, depending on your broker, okay, depending on what type of broker they are, you might see significant rise in spreads during the Asian session. That's because it has become apparent for quite a while now that retail traders use that time, that Asian session time, to basically scalp and make those small price pips. And it's much easier to actually trade ranges in the Asian session than it would be to trade during the London or the New York session. So that would be the time thing, right? So you'd have to wake up for the Asian session. Let's say still working full time, you have to wake up for the Asian session, spend an hour or two trading during that time, right? Then obviously go back to sleep if there's nothing. You just go back to sleep. But typically, Asian session, and depending obviously on how many markets that you are watching, will produce a lot of sideways ranging markets that are really good for reversal scalping, right? Okay, just we're all on the same page. Okay, now I also got this question. Someone asked me regarding what trading robots can achieve in relation to that $100 a day theory. Now, earning $100 every single day is highly unlikely for a trading system, but it's actually not impossible because, right, a trading system will trade a method exactly the way that it's programmed to do, no matter what the conditions. Okay, it doesn't look whether there is fundamental news coming out, for example, right, and therefore it needs to adjust stop loss or adjust take profit or whatever the case may be, right? It may be able to read what news is coming out if it's major news and not trade during that time, but it can't make decisions, complex decisions like a human would. So whether the market is ranging sideways, it's moving sideways, or it's trending, it's still going to apply the same sort of trading rules, right? Is there a break above the moving average? You buy. A break below the moving average, you sell. It doesn't care. And with that, it does tend to have, let's say if it's a really good one, it will probably have a day or two of losing trades. But it can't really make profits every single day. Okay. Highly, and it's not probable that it can make money each and every single day, because some days the market will behave in a way that it basically doesn't understand. It'll just use the same trading rules. Right? So you're going to have two or three bad ones. But obviously a trading system or trading robot needs to have a verified track record of the past, at least to say, okay, it's been consistent. It has produced this amount of money, right? It just doesn't need to say, all right, yeah, no, it works. It's because they're not the same, right? They all have different trading rules, stop losses, take profits. And I mean, there's a bunch of them, some free, some extremely expensive, some affordable, right? But what I've found is that they can't really adjust. So if you can adjust it regularly, I'm pretty certain that you can actually do it, because there is one that I've been using since for about 6 months or so now. It's just that I decide which direction I wanted to trade in, and then I just help it with that. That's okay, so today GBP USD looks like it's gonna rise, and then it basically does the entries, the exit, the stop losses, and the basic trade management. So it's actually quite a neat tool. Okay. So basically, in a nutshell, what you need to do from this point going forward, because like I've mentioned earlier, you can make $100 on average per day, right? But you first need to really understand what your risk appetite actually is, right? So if you have, let's say, a high pain tolerance, and you can take losing $20, $30, or $50 out of a $100 trading account, that's 50% drawdown, by the way, then by all means, you can fund a small account and you can start hitting it hard, as long as you have a trading system or trading strategy that is short term, right? Because you can't do that with a position trading strategy or a swing trading strategy. You need something that's going to be in, out of the markets, in, out of the markets. And preferably, you need to have a very low spread broker that you're going to be scalping with, right? Examples of that would be, let's say, an ECN account with FX Open, okay? ICE Markets, Tickmill, you know, I think Tickmill is one of the cheaper ones. So those would be the preferable brokers, for example, for short-term scalping, right? Well, scalping, basically. So find a nice short-term scalping strategy. Obviously, as I said, if you need help with that, you can drop a WhatsApp message. Now, test the strategy, all right? Now, one way to test the strategy is to actually go back and look at price action and just apply manually where you'd get in, where you'd get out. Or you can use a trading simulator, right, and just punch in a bunch of numbers and test and actually trade using past data. Let's say from 2015 to now, you can actually trade placing your stop loss where it would be. Let's say if the trading strategy has a template, you place the template itself right on the trading simulator, and you can literally buy and sell using 2015 data. It's actually quite brilliant, and you can trade 1 year's worth of data in about an hour or two, and you get like stats about, all right, this is the amount of trades you've won, this is the amount of trades you've lost, and this is the average amount of pips, and this is how much the strategy has actually made for the past 5 years. I mean, if that doesn't give you confidence in at least forward testing your strategy, nothing will. Right? So test your strategy. Deposit at least $100 to $1,000 to forward test the strategy. Right. So when I say deposit $100 to $1,000 to forward test, I just basically mean demo. Right. So you demo trade it with not 10,000 euros or $100,000 or $1 million demo account. Right. That won't really help you much. It needs to be close or exactly the amount that you want to start off your trading account with, right? Because it just basically means you'll be able to see realistic expectation as opposed to funding $1 million trading account and trading 10 lots or 20 lots when you're actually going to fund your trading account, your live account, with $10. Right, so trade it for a month targeting $10. So the demo account, target $10 a day on average. So at the end of the week, you need to come out with at least $50. Okay. And then you can fund your real account. And yeah, if everything is done properly, back test, forward test, and all of that is done accordingly, then you definitely start to make money. So if you guys do have any questions regarding what we've done, now would be the best time to do so. Okay. If you guys have any questions, now would be the best time to ask them. So in the meantime, I'll just go over what I have been talking about for the past couple of days in the Telegram channel, is that you can subscribe to the premium NASDAQ signals on through the WhatsApp group. Right. So as I mentioned, I'm giving them out for free. But I'm only doing that for 20 guys. Right. So I think right now we are at 13, if I'm not mistaken, probably 13 or something like that. So you just basically need to have a live trading account with a minimum amount of 100 USD, right? Minimum amount of 100 USD, okay? Because, I mean, I started off with $500 minimum balance, and I was like, okay, a lot of people were like, no, can you just bring it down a bit? So that was me basically, I can say, buckling under the pressure, because NASDAQ, I prefer to have a bit of a higher deposit balance or minimum balance for that, okay, for obvious reasons. But we'll be starting off afresh on Monday. I'm going to be starting off afresh the signals on Monday. So if you like access to that, just kindly WhatsApp 0631742621. But let me just drop the link in the Telegram channel. So it's just going to take you directly there. So it does seem like we don't have any more questions. We have got 8 minutes left in tonight's session. So if you guys don't have any more questions, right, make sure to text for the PDF to get the strategies and also anything related to the NASDAQ signals. You can simply WhatsApp the number that is showing on your screen right now. And thank you guys for coming through today. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the evening and everyone is keeping safe during this very testing time. Okay. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your weekend. Enjoy your weekend and okay. Okay, so daily routine walkthrough. I'm not quite sure I understand the question. Not quite sure if I understand the question. Can you try and rephrase that for me?